As a result of all that dream, Jeff Jarrett counted out. They lose the match. See, apparently admiring his tights. And now we have signed Jeff Jarrett, Steve Mongo McMichael at Super Brawl 7, and a very important match in the career of Jeff Jarrett. If he wins, he will be a part of the Horsemen. Now, I don't know if that means someone's going to get booted out if he wins, or they're going to be five Horsemen now. I'm not so sure the implications there. But I do know what I see, and I see a beautiful lady, that she is, having some infatuation for another man while her husband is wrestling in the ring.
Man, that, I mean, I'm just looking at you explain that. When you say, yeah, admiring his tights is one thing, infatuation is another. And I guarantee you, there's something going on here. Good point you brought up. I gotta talk about for 1 second. My belief is that Chris Benoit, Mongo McMichael, Jeff Jarrett, and one other man will form the new four Horsemen. I believe it's headed that way. I believe if Jarrett wins this thing, he gets into the secret code, if you will, the club, because I really believe Iron Anderson and the Nature Boy Ric Flair got the handful with these young lions. That's just my opinion.
And both are really on the sidelines right now with injuries.
Yes, and that's hard. It's hard to play. You know, like you've been playing, you've been a starter, Tony, and you've been playing here on Saturday night for all the years that I've known you a little body. I've known you a long time. You're Jeff Jarrett's real school, and this match, the outcome really is in no doubt. But I want to tell you, he could slip up. But you are playing this game. You be sick for 3 weeks, and they put somebody in here. You know what I mean? And you start sitting home, man, I need to get well. But pretty soon, the ratings start going high because me and this person get along so well, and I'm so talented, and the ratings are going high, and they are, and they can't get much higher, and they are. And they say, hey, you can't play with us no more. That would hurt you, wouldn't it? That'd be big, and that ain't gonna happen. But in the Four Horsemen, if you're on the sideline sick right now, injured and hurt, and these young lions are running around, Tony, a change is coming over the house of the Horsemen. That's all I'm saying. Does that make any sense, or did I just go off?
Well, both, really. Here's a pickup and a power slam.
Both, really?
One, two, got a two count. Villano, four.
Both.
The masked man, we've seen him now for two straight weeks. He'll be at Super Brawl.
Who is this, Valine?
Six-man tag, and Jeff Jarrett is in trouble here. Villano,
yeah.
Four is up on top. And boy, oh, boy.
He's another fine athlete and coming from Mexico. But I just really believe he's in there. I'm going to go back to this thing where Piper Hogan and Jeff Jarrett and everybody involved in this situation. Now, tradition, history is in the ring right here with Jeff Jarrett.
No question about that. Jeff Jarrett and Mongo McMichael, they battled before. This time it's a lot on the line as far as Jeff Jarrett is concerned.
I want to say to Piper also, don't get your head cut off. Don't get in a situation to where you think that by going crazy right off the bat is going to get you into Hogan's thing. Hogan's game plan is almost unbeatable. You got to really be right for him. And we know Betty by time can come very easy when Piper hooks you in the sleeper, right or wrong. Emotional. What a pay-per-view. This will be a Super Brawl in the Cow Palace in San Francisco.
Villano 4 stayed with it and got a two count, almost got a three count that time on Jeff Jarrett.
Yeah, Villano 4 really trying to make his mark in WCW.
Backside, one, two.
Villano 4.
And a big running lariat that time from Jeff Jarrett. Super Brawl 7, Piper Hogan, world title on the line. Roddy Piper in a frame of mind that we haven't seen in many, many years from that man. Truly,
wow.
The icon, truly That's one of the most successful wrestlers the sport will ever know.
Yeah.
And his chance of the world title, and a man who is on the cusp of being a wild man right now.
Yeah, and he's got one shot, I really believe, one good shot left in him. I believe he's going to throw it at Super Brawl. I really believe he's going to throw it, brother.
Oh, boy.
Like that right there. Speaking of good shots.
That was a great one.
Jeff Jarrett hung him up. I was chasing a Bobby Jones in the backyard, and he ran into a clothesline like that. It looked just like that.
Did
a regular really? Clothesline.
A real clothesline.
With feet went there and hung him up. My mama looked out there and said, he hung him up. Virgil, come here. He hung him up.
The whip into the corner to the other side. Villano 4 hits hard. And Jeff Jarrett, you know, Jeff Jarrett has never been lacking for confidence. And that's one horseman trait that Flair and Anderson have always liked. You got to be cocky. You got to feel that you can do just about anything. And Jarrett's like that. Villano 4, 1, 2. And that cockiness almost cost him that time.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you what, Villano 4 is a fine athlete. He wouldn't have came here from Mexico in the WCW, but not being right here now, cracked down on that leg, maybe tried to step into that figure four, made famous by the head of the horseman. We're talking about the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. But will this be a new horseman? Will Jeff Jarrett join the ranks of Mongo McMichaels, Chris Benoit, and the injuries suffered laden Iron Anderson and Nature Boy, Ric Flair?
Hooks in the figure four. On Villano 4, and this one is over. Jeff Jarrett is your winner, demanding the hand be raised.
Yeah.
By Mark Curtis, it is. And Jarrett is your winner here on Saturday night.
Strutting his stuff, baby. Right across your silver screen.
Gonna be going to Lee Marshall in a few moments as Jarrett will make his way to the locker room area to talk to Lee.
Oh, yeah. That's how you do it. McMichael, take a good look. I've taken down Benoit. I've taken down all the horses.
Yes, you have. Energy. You've had McMichael. Quite a win streak. And
oh, yeah.
We're going to be seeing Jeff in just a moment in the locker room. Here it is again, Drew.
Well, you got to duck under and think about this situation when Mongo McMichaels comes to mind. He's the big, bad new enforcer, if you will. They called him. Jeff Jarrett's got to beat him. To be in any club, though, you got to go ahead and beat the bully of the club, and then they might accept you. Bottom line right here. Jumping into the figure four, made famous by the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Jeff Jarrett moving to the pay window, as I said on Saturday night. The mothership standing by, Stagger Lee Marshall talking with Jeff Jarrett.
Dusty, Tony, thanks very much. Don't forget Super Brawls. And in that event, coming from San Francisco, a match that could literally reshape the face of professional wrestling. That's because this man, Jeff Jarrett, fresh from a win you just saw, looking fine, I'll give you that. But can we talk about Super Brawl? You and McMichael, if you beat Mongo, then unquestionably, you become a horseman.
Oh, 2 weeks from tomorrow night.
Correct.
Some 6 months ago, when I came strolling into World Championship Wrestling, Ric Flair saw that I could walk the walk and talk the talk, and he so-called, to use your words, he knighted me.
Mm-hmm.
And then, who didn't like it? Chris Benoit,
right.
The first member of the Four Horsemen. Well, at Starcade, I pinned his shoulders to the mat, 1, 2, 3. And then Arn Anderson, some 2 or 3 weeks ago, he didn't like some comments that Jeff Jarrett had to say. Well, the truth hurt. Oh, and you know what else hurt? Me pinning his shoulders to the mat in the ring, 1, 2, 3. And now Mongo McMichael. Oh, it's finally come to this. The match that all the people, all the Four Horsemen have been waiting for. If I win, I'm in the most elite group in all of professional wrestling. There's a lot of history.
Yeah, that's true. Let me tell you one more person that's got a vested interest. That's Deborah McMichael. What's up with that,
Jeff? Lee, she is just like Ric Flair.
How's
when
that?
She sees talent, she knows it, and she sees it in Jeff Jarrett. And after it's all said and done at Super Brawl, I'm going to be the man that's going to be leading the Four Horsemen.
All he's got to do, and I mean all he's got to do, is beat Mongo McMichael at Super Brawl. Call your cable operator now. We're coming back with more action on Saturday night. Don't you dare go away.